Hi students, myself Praveen MB, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, Sri D. Devarajaras, JFGC Hunsuru. In this session, we'll be seeing .NET Lab programs of 6th semester of BSc CS course under the University of Mysore for the academic year 2019-20. So the first program goes like this. Write a program to display three images in a line. When any of the images is clicked, it must be displayed below. On clicking the displayed image, it must be cleared. What it says is that we need to display three images beside each other in a single line. And when any of them is clicked, it should be displayed below. And on clicking the displayed image, that should be cleared. Right? So this is the first program. So let us start writing the code and executing it. As we have already seen what is the ASP.NET and how to create a project and what is the server, how the ASP.NET project is hosted on the server, and how it opens in the browser, all those things we have seen it. Thus, we'll be straight away going to write the code and then execute. So, open the Visual Studio. Let me wait for the Visual Studio to open. Yeah, it got opened. Then, what to do? We will first go to File, click on New Project, then type in the search box as web. You will get two types of web applications. One is ASP.NET web application of Visual C Sharp or C Hash. Another is for Visual Basics. Select Visual C Sharp and give the project name as Lab Program 1. Fine. Then in the solution explorer, the project appears. Let me maximize the window. Then go to the design tab. Here we'll be designing the page. For that, I need to have three images. For that, click on the toolbox and click on the image, select the image button and drag and drop it on the page and just resize it. And I need three images, right? So three placeholders for the images in a single line. Just copy it and here give some space and paste it. Right, if you see, this placeholder is called as image button 2. Right, similarly, just give some more space and give a placeholder for third image. Right, then I also need to display the image when any of this image is clicked. For that also I need to have a placeholder. So for that I'm also pasting once again. So this is called as image button 4. There are totally 4 placeholders for images. This first placeholder is image button 1, this is image button 2, image button 3 and image button 4. To display image in this, I need to have images in my project. Right? I have a images in my local computer. I'll just open pictures. Here I have a folder wherein there are images. I'm just copy that and I'll paste in this project. Right, so you got these images. Now right click on this placeholder, go to properties. Here in the bottom right corner, you will get a properties window. You will have an image URL and click on those three dots. Click on images and select first picture. That would be appearing in the first placeholder. Similarly, do it for the other two. Image URL, click on the three dots, select the second image, click on OK. Similarly, go to the properties of third placeholder, click on third picture and click on OK. So now these three images will be displayed. And if I click on this, this image should display in the bottom placeholder. And if I click on the second picture, that should be displayed on the bottom placeholder. Right? So for this scenario, if I click, what should happen? If I click, the image URL of this first placeholder should be put up in the image URL of the fourth placeholder. Thus, for this to happen, we'll write a backend code, that is C# code. So here there is a method called as imageButton1_click. So when a button 1 is clicked, that is imageButton1 is clicked, right? So what should happen? That code you have to write here. So what should happen? imageButton4.imageURL should be put up with a value of the imageButton1's image URL. So through this, what happens? Once the imageButton1 is clicked, the control flow will come here and this will execute this. What it says here, the imageButton1 image URL should be put up in the imageButton4's image URL. So through this, whatever you click here, that will be displayed in this fourth placeholder. And similarly, if I click my second picture or a placeholder, what should happen? The image4's image URL should be put up with the image2's image URL. Similarly, if a third image is clicked, this should also put image4's image URL with the image URL 3.image URL. So what happens here, if I click this, the image URL of this is transferred to this, and this here also in the bottom placeholder, the corresponding image will be displayed. Then if I click on this displayed image, this should get cleared. So if I double click on that, it will get me to the C# code. Here if I click on the imageButton4, the imageButton4's image URL should be get cleared. That's why we put a empty strings. Okay, whatever the image that displayed previously here would be disappearing once I click this. Because if I click this, the control flow goes to the imageButton4_click method, wherein I am saying the image URL of that has to be put up with the empty strings. Thus, the image will be disappearing here if I click on this displayed image. Right? So let us run it and see, does it work the same way or not. Right? So if I click on the first image, the first image should be displayed down. Right? Similarly, if I click on second, the second image should be displayed down. Similarly, third image also, it should get displayed in the fourth placeholder. And if I click on this displayed image, that should be cleared. Right? Yes. So this is working as per the requirement. Thus, this completes the coding and executing of the lab program 1. Thank you.